Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is part five of solving problems with angles and triangles, and in this video, we use our knowledge of angles and geometry to find the measure of an angle given a diagram. We do three problems. The third one does not involve a triangle, so just our knowledge of angles. All right, we're going to do this geometry problem. Find the measure of angle A. All right, so we have to see what's given here. We know this angle over here is 100 degrees, and so since together with this angle over here, it has to add up to 180. Remember, these are supplementary angles. How big would this be? That would be 80 degrees, so we could draw that in. And what about right here, the 105 degrees? If we add these two angles together, it has to be 180 degrees, so that one would have to be 75 degrees. Now, if we know two angles in a triangle, we could figure out this third angle over here. So we know that 80 plus 75 plus, let's just call this x, we know that has to add up to 180 degrees. So if you want to write an equation to figure that out, you can. Some of you can do that in your head. We know that we've got, I'm going to make this simple. I'm going to subtract 80 from both sides first. So I get x plus 75 equals 100 degrees, so x is 25 degrees. Now, of course, you could have added and got x plus 155 and then subtracted 155 from both sides. You're still going to get x equals 25. So we know this angle here for x is 25 degrees. So we figured out that that was 25 degrees. Now we know what a plus that 25 has to add up to 180 as well. So a plus 25, and I'm going to leave off the degree symbol on this one, and in the end, remember to write our answer in degrees. So we're going to have to subtract 25 from both sides. So A is 155 degrees. Now here's something interesting you may have noticed. This adds up to 155 and this adds up to 155. And my answer over here is 155. And that's going to be true because these three angles inside the triangle, the interior angles, have to add up to 180. So 25 plus these two angles is 80, and 25 plus angle A has to add up to 180. So it makes sense that A really is the same thing as the sum of 80 plus 75. In any case, we found the measure of angle A. Measures 155, and remember to write our answer in degrees. Here's another problem for you to try. Find the measure of angle B. Okay, so put the video on pause and try this on your own first. All right, so we have to see what we know here. We know that this is 120 degrees, and remember the angle, these are called vertical angles right here. So this over here has to also be 120 degrees. Okay. Now, what do we know about this angle here? If this is 160, it's supplementary with this other angle over here because that forms a straight line. So those have to add up to 180 degrees. So that should be 20 degrees. So I've got 120 degrees and 20 degrees inside this triangle, right? So what would this third angle be? And of course, that third angle will be the same thing as whatever B is, right? Because those are vertical. So if I want, I can even say, well, if this is B, I know inside here that's also B. And these three angles add up to 180. So that's how we could write our equation. And there's more than one way of figuring this out. This is just one way that came to mind for me. So I've got B plus 140 degrees, 180 degrees. Subtract 140 from both sides. And we've got B is 40 degrees. So our The answer, I forgot to say, find the measure of angle B. Forgot to say what I was looking for. So the answer is B measures 40 degrees. All right, here's another problem. Find the measure of angle A. See if you could do this one on your own from the information given in this picture. All right, what do we have here? We have a right angle right here. Remember, that means this is 90 degrees. But this part is 55 degrees, so we should be able to figure out this part over here. We know that 55 plus that angle has to add up to 90 degrees. So what would that be? That would be 35 degrees. Now, you could write an equation to figure that out first if you'd like. You would say 55 plus x, or whatever you want to call it, equals 90. But notice that these two add up to 90 degrees. So now how are we going to get angle A? Well, these two have to add up to 180. So then, if you want, you could write an equation. A plus 35 equals 180. I'm leaving off the degrees, but keep in mind at the end, I'm going to have to write that down. So A would be 145. So the answer here is 145 degrees. So we're using our knowledge of geometry, about the different angles, about the angles in the triangle, etc., to figure out other angles. I could have had an angle over here, B, and said, you know, how big is angle B? And hopefully you could do that. You know, altogether these two would have to add up to 180, etc. So there's a lot of different questions that could be asked. You just have to use your knowledge of what a right triangle is, your knowledge of supplementary angles to more than one angle, I mean two angles that add up to 180 degrees, etc. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.